On 25th, we have the transaction goods withdrawn for domestic use. Goods withdrawn for domestic use. So domestic use means personal use. So here we have goods withdrawn. Which goods can be withdrawn? Goods purchased can be withdrawn. Who is withdrawing the goods? Generally, it is the owner who takes the goods for his personal use. So whenever it is personal use, we use the word drawings, which is nothing but representing owner. The word drawings is representing owner. So owner is a person. Drawing is personal account. Now let us see if the personal account rule. Debit the receiver. So when owner is taking home the goods or withdrawing the goods, he is the receiver. So therefore we will debit him. So it is drawings account debit. Two. Now which goods are being taken home? Purchased goods. So when we purchased goods, we have put it under the word purchases. So we will credit purchases account based on the rule of real account, because goods are going out. So our journal entry would be drawings account debit to purchases account. The amount is 5,000. Your narration could be being goods withdrawn by the owner. Now the next transaction is on 27th, which says that cash received from Anand 4,000 and discount allowed 50. So we have received cash. So one account is cash and there is discount allowed. So discount allowed means we are giving a concession to the person who is paying the cash. So when we are giving concession to someone, it is a loss. So we take our discount allowed as a loss. So there is a loss. So when there is a loss, it becomes nominal account. Then there is cash, which is real account. Then who is giving this cash? Anand. So Anand is a which account? Personal. This is I've written for your understanding. Now we have cash, which is a real account. When you have received cash, real account is coming in. Debit what comes in. So we say cash account debit. So cash account debit would be 4,000. Now you are giving him a concession of 50 rupees. So this concession of 50 rupees is a loss to you. Based on the rule of nominal, we are debiting the loss. So 50. Now, who is giving us this money? Anand is giving, and Anand is personal account. So therefore, the personal account rule of credit the giver, we will apply for Anand and credit his account. So to Anand's account. So ultimately, your journal entry is becoming cash account debit 4,000, discount allowed account debit 50. To Anand's account, we have to credit Anand with 4,050. So this entry we already discussed. We called it as a compound journal entry. And your narration would be being cash received from Anand and discount allowed. Now, next. Next entry is interest received. On 28th, you have interest received. On 28th, you have interest received. So, interest is nothing but the periodical payment given by a bank or when you have some investment elsewhere, etc. So, received means cash. So, we have two things here. We have cash which we are getting. Now, why we are getting? We are telling it is interest. So, we have another word, interest. Now, this interest is received periodically. Any amount that is received periodically is called as an income. And income is categorized as which account? Nominal account. So, here we have interest, which is nominal account and it is an income. And cash, which is a real account. So, apply the rule of real account for the cash. So, we are getting cash. So, debit what comes in, so we are debiting cash. Now we have identified interest, here is income and it is a nominal. The rule of nominal account will apply and we say credit all income and gains, so that's why we are crediting interest account. We are crediting interest because it is income and applying the rule of nominal account. So the entry is cash account debit to interest account 500, cash account debit to interest account 500 being interest received, that is on 28th. Then moving on to 29th, on 29th it is said the transaction is cash paid to Raman 4900 after receiving a discount of 100. So here we have a person called Raman, and to whom we have to pay money, and we are paying, and we have cash which we have paid, and also we are getting a concession of 100 rupees from this person. So when we get concession, we call it as discount received. We call it as discount received. So when we see Raman, immediately we imagine personal account. When we see cash, we imagine real account. When we see discount, and here it is a concession, we have to remember nominal account. So let us see first the amounts that are given here. It is said cash paid to Raman. Cash paid to Raman means cash would be going out. So applying the rule of real account, credit what goes out, we credit cash. So to cash account, so how much it is? Cash we paid 4900. Now we received a discount of 100. It is a gain for us. Credit all incomes and gains, the rule of nominal. So we credit discount received. So to discount received 100, and actually we know that Raman has to give us total 5000. Why 5000? Because we have to pay to Raman 5000. Why? Because we have given him cash of 4900 and we are getting a concession of 100. Had we not got this concession, we would have paid 5000. So therefore we will debit Raman with 5000. So that is your journal entry. Your narration could be being cash paid to Raman and discount received. Coming to the last transaction on 31, it is commission paid. Commission paid means you are paying money, and why are you paying money? Because someone has given you some service for which you are paying. So commission would be an expense for you. So expenses fall under the category of nominal account, and when you see the rule of nominal account, debit all expenses and losses. Therefore we are debiting commission. Paid means cash is going out. So real account, credit what goes out. So the journal entry becoming commission account debit to cash 300. So narration would be being commission paid.